Good morning, students. So this is a part 2 of the chapter, the fundamental unit of life, and this is chapter number 5 of your NCERT, and it is presented by me, Pooja Verma. So till now we have just dealt with the introductory portion. Now in this video we will dealing with the discovery of a cell and its components and the cell theory. So let's get started. So the first topic is the discovery of cell. The first name over here we observed is Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke is a scientist who observed the thin slice of a cork. Cork is substance that obtained from the bark of a tree. Okay. So Robert Hooke saw that the cork resemble, okay, that cork is being resembling with a honeycomb like structure, and he basically named these structures as cell. The term cell is being derived from the Latin term cella. Cella means what? Small compartments. So basically Robert Hooke is observed a small honeycomb like structures, and he named these structures as cell. Cell means what? A little room. Okay, and students, he observed these observation. He basically made these observation through a self-designed microscope. Okay, Robert Hooke designed a microscope which we termed as simple microscope. So Robert Hooke in the year 1665 observed that dead slice of a cork and found the small honeycomb like structures. He named those structures as cell, that means small compartments, by using his primitive microscope. The next name which we observe is Antony von Leeuwenhoek. So student, Antony von Leeuwenhoek observed in the pond water. How? He observed minute microscopic organism. Microscopic organism means what? Those organisms that are only being observed under a microscope. Okay, so he basically taken a drop of pond water, and there he observed the minute microscopic organism. Okay, and he did not name it as cell. Antony von Leeuwenhoek named it as animalcules. Okay, after that we have another name, Robert Brown, in the year 1831. So he basically discovered the nucleus inside the cell. So in this topic we basically dealt with the Robert Hooke. That is, Robert Hooke in the year 1665 was the first person who observed the honeycomb like compartments in the dead slice of a cork, and he named those compartments as cell, which means small room like structure, by using his primitive microscope. After that we study about Antony von Leeuwenhoek. He basically observed the rainwater on the pond water, and there he observed the minute microscopic organism, and he named it as animalcules. And Robert Brown in the year 1831, he basically discovered nucleus inside the cell. Coming to the next topic, that is cell theory. So basically the cell theory is being proposed by two scientists, a German botanist M.J. Sleiden and a German zoologist Tudor Swan in the year 1838 and 1839 respectively. Okay, and both of them gave two important postulates. That is, the first one is that all living organisms are made up of one or more cells. Okay, that means every living organism has cells as its basic unit. And the second postulate is the cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organism. Okay, so student, work of these two scientists, okay, basically make a way for the formulation of a cell theory in which these two important basic postulates are there, which is proposed by Sladen and Swan in the year 1838 and in the year 1839 respectively. Now, in the year 1855 or 58 approx, another name, Rudolf Virchow, came, and he is German pathologist. He basically gave what this term, ominous cellular e cellula. And what does it mean? It means that all cell arise from pre-existing cells. Now, what do you mean by pre-existing cells? Pre-existing का मतलब होता है something जो nature में पहले से ही है, पहले से ही मौजूद है. Okay? So, Rudolf Virchow, by this ominous cellular, e cellular, make another postulate that all cell arise from pre-existing cell. Okay? He given this in Latin, and the comprehension is as all cells arise from pre-existing cells. So till now, students, we have studied about the three important postulates in the cell theory. The first one is all living organisms are made up of one or more cells. The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organism. And the latest third one is all cells arise from pre-existing cell. So till here, what we can conclude that what we have studied, that a cell is the structural and functional unit of all the living organisms, okay, and it is capable of to exist independently and perform all the basic and essential functions of life. Okay, the third, we can say that a cell is basically microscopic. Microscopic means what? Something that can't be seen by our naked eye, and that in an instrument microscope is being used to observe. Okay, and according to the cell theory, these three important postulates is there. So till here, in the next top video, we are going to covering the cell shape and size and the type of the cell, that is prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So stay tuned for this, and thank you so much.